1:16 said, wash you, make you clean, put away the evil of your doings from before my eyes, cease to do evil. He says, put away your foreign gods, wash yourself, cleanse yourself. Get rid of some of this stuff.
Yes.
Third, there's changing. He says, change your clothes.
Yeah.
This symbolizes that they were putting off the old life of sin and putting on a new life of godliness.
Yeah.
The Bible says in verse 6, so Jacob came to Luz, that is Bethel, which is in the land of Canaan, and he and all the people who were with him. Verse 7, and he built an altar there and called the place El Bethel, which means God of the house of God, because there God appeared to him when he fled from his brother. It was as if Jacob was saying to his family, watch this, I am the head of this family. I have not set a good example. But the hour has come for reparation. The hour has come for reformation. The hour has come for a decisive and radical change to take place. So let's go back to Bethel. Let us seek to repair what ought to be repaired, to undo what ought to be undone, and to carry out what the Lord would have his family to do. Let us go back to Bethel. Let us spiritually revive our family. Let me just close. Let me close, because I know some of you got dinner and lunch appointments. I mean lunch reservations. I really believe that's the step that is needed in our homes.
Amen.
Like Jacob, we need to take stock of our moral and spiritual condition.
Yes.
We need to take a full and faithful inventory of our homes. Fathers, we who are to be the heads and the priests of the family need to ask ourselves, have we been callous and forgetful and unfaithful as Jacob was for so many years? Need to take inventory. And if we have, we need to go back to God. We need to accept our responsibility as the head of our families. And where we need to renew our promises to God and move toward a new life of victory. Because you will never have a victorious life in your own life or in the life of your family as long as you are hanging out in Shechem.
Amen.
When Bethel is your destination. Let's have a witness in here. You can't be close to Bethel. Let me close. How many times I said that?